cheer you up, Josh.
SmackDown's number one announcer.
You know, you had to put up with Rene Dupree, but, you know, now you get Funaki.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, approaching the ring from Japan, weighing in at 180 pounds, Funaki.
You know what you gotta love about Funaki? Keeps it simple. Has the same gear, loyal to SmackDown, you know.
You're always checking him out, aren't you, Steve?
Gotta check out the gear, brother. You know how it is. Now, who's this? Juventud? Is he the dude?
And weighing in at 160 pounds, Juventud.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have never seen this man before, you are in for a treat. Juventud on Velocity. Juventud from WCW. He was a four-time Cruiserweight champion, a tag team champion with Rey Mysterio, an IWGP Junior Heavyweight champion, a WWA Junior Heavyweight champion, and a WWA Lightweight champion.
You know, I hate to admit it sometimes, but when I ask you who is this, you came through with money that time. I love it. I actually don't, but, you know, I'd give you some props.
Juventud has been all over the world and back, and it is great to have him here on Velocity from Mexico City, Mexico.
Well, that right there in my book makes him all right.
Oh, you're Mexican too.
Well, there you go.
Little national pride here on Velocity. You know, it was Flag Day in the United States this past week.
It was.
I was giving out American flags.
You were? You know what, Josh? You're a true patriot.
Yes, I am.
And right now, an international matchup here, and Juventud, no doubt, a high flyer. Funaki, almost a quick cover, but these two are flying about the ring. Look at Juventud, on fire.
And the fans in this arena respecting Juventud and Funaki. Great chain wrestling to start off this match. A couple of sweeps into some covers, and now we're ready to go. These two just feeling each other out.
Funaki, wondering what he's into here. Juventud obviously with some great speed and obviously some strength here. Funaki with a nice counter though and a nice kick to the abdomen.
Funaki and Juventud have never ever been in the ring together before. This is the first time you are seeing this anywhere.
Tilt the world head scissors by Funaki. Great move. Got Juventud a bit off guard.
Another standoff. Yeah, you're right. Juventud, he does feel off guard right here, I believe.
How quickly will he regroup?
Juventud again now wants to show respect.
And then show Funaki that he's got a little fire to him, I believe, Josh. Oh! A jump back kick by Juventud and starts hammering away on Funaki with the snapmare off the ropes and that drop kick. That's nasty.
See just how quick Juventud is in the ring. He has been in the ring with some of the greatest cruiserweights in the world and now challenging another great one in Funaki.
Juventud with the suplex, and Josh, you see guys that are very quickly, superstars that are very quick. He puts three or four combinations together, three or four different moves together, bang, bang, bang.
So fast right here. Check out how fast Juventud hits those ropes and then driving that elbow into Funaki.
Cover on Funaki by Juventud. Just a count to one, Funaki able to kick out.
Shut up!
Will Orlando Jordan able to retain the United States Championship?
Back.
But Jordan
that
had to cheat to keep Hardcore Holly from taking that gold.
Well, that was after the Bashams quit the cabinet, leaving JBL and Orlando high and dry. Orlando had to go at it all alone, and he did. He cheated, and he defeated Hardcore Holly the same way he cheated a couple of weeks ago, last week on Velocity.
Well, it may become a general theme for JBL and Orlando now because they're short two members of the cabinet as the Bashams have signed their walking papers.
Well, what was JBL going to do as he only had Orlando to watch his back as he took on The Undertaker in a no disqualification match on SmackDown? We'll find out.
Oh, Funaki was showing tremendous strength here, Josh, able to get up to his feet, and then Juventud falls back on his back. Big time shot by Funaki.
A lot of separation here. Here comes Juventud.
Oh, Funaki heard him coming. Moves just in time. Juventud bangs out the ropes, wondering what's going on here.
Welcome to the WWE, Juventud.
a little stunned by that, Josh. Maybe a little dazed as he struggled to get to the ropes. And Funaki right now opening up with a couple of big right hands. Back body drop by Funaki on Juventud.
Funaki's lighting up Juventud like a Christmas tree.
Funaki with the bulldog on Juventud. This could be it, the cover two. And just in time, Juventud able to get out. Funaki frustrated, thought he had the match, Josh.
Funaki should stay on Juventud right now. I know Funaki has seen Juventud in the ring before, and Funaki knows what he has to do in order to win this match.
Josh, Funaki took his eyes off Juventud for just a minute, may cost him, but no, Funaki comes back. What strength that was. Funaki had all his weight on Juventud, and Juventud able to kick out.
And Juve stacked up on his shoulders there, was able to escape.
Tremendous, tremendous high-flying quick action by these cruiserweights.
Tornado DDT countered.
He tried to go for it, couldn't get it done. Juventud with a great counter. Oh! Funaki finding a way to get it done, but not quite.
A tremendous exchange of moves by these two tremendous superstars.
Josh, just when you think one of these superstars has made an advantage, has made a little leeway in this match, the other comes up with a tremendous counter.
Funaki going for another
just
win
like
right
this.
Here.
What a tremendous move by Juventud. He's got Funaki on his back to count to two. Funaki saves the day and is able to get up. Abdominal stretch into a slam by Juventud, bringing out the entire arsenal, and that is it, Josh.
Here's your winner, Juventud.
Well, suffice it to say, I think we will see plenty more of this guy.
Talk about making an impact early. Juventud in his first match on the WWE, picking up the victory. Welcome to SmackDown at Velocity, Juventud.